He's prepared to stand for his own. Whatever thing that you want to do, as concerns the things of God, it is always good for you to see how it moves. For you to see actually how you have laid down yourself to God. You have laid down your life. You have surrendered yourself. How is it moving? What is your connectivity with God? What type of intimate life are you preserving to God? And what are you also presenting? You have to preserve your life for Him alone. Your preservation and your presentation counts. And your preparedness. How are you prepared? How are you prepared? Give us life. Take everything to the kingdom of God. We are praying of a living God, not a living God, not a dead God. A living God, not a dead God. How prepared are you? How is your life? How is your life? Connect yourself. Connect yourself. Surrender yourself. Give everything that you do have. Give everything. Give everything. Your goodness is running after you. We owe no songs right. We owe no rights to the songs. We owe no rights to the songs. Your goodness is running after me. Your goodness is running after me. Your goodness is running after me. How is the goodness of God running after you? That is what you have to ask yourself. You can't stop praising God until you witness the goodness of God running after you. You can't. Till you see that goodness, till you feel that goodness, till you touch that goodness, till you hold that goodness of God running after you. Without, there is no possible way. There is no means that you can say the goodness of God is running after you. The goodness of run is something that is of perfection. And you need to be spiritual, actually to be spiritual. Be connected. Prayer, fasting, sacrifice moves you closer and closer to God. Yeah. Have that intimacy. Know God for yourself. Be your own pastor. Mm-hmm. Be your own prophet. Be your own prophetess. Be your own apostle. Mm-hmm. Be your own teacher. Have that personal relationship with God. That you can sit anywhere and call His name because He's ready to answer. The angels of God are highly connected with you. Mm-hmm. Connect yourself. Mm-hmm. Connect yourself. Connect yourself. Yes, connect yourself. Yes. Connect yourself. Connect yourself. Connect yourself. Connect yourself. Connect yourself. Connect yourself. Connect yourself, brethren. Connect yourself. Forget about anything that is pulling you behind. You don't have to go 10 steps and 15 steps behind. No. You move 10 steps ahead. 10 steps ahead. 10 steps ahead. Amen. Yes. Amen. There is nothing that can pull you behind. Nothing can pull you behind. You keep on going. You keep on going. Not arithmetically. Geometrically. You keep on moving. You keep on moving. You keep on moving. Nothing can stop you. What do you have to do? Simple. Have the belief in God. Have faith in God. You will see Him and you will feel Him.
Amen.
Take that intimacy with God. That intimacy with God. Believe in Him. God is not man. God is not man. God is not man. The devil uses all type of offenses as concerns us. Why? Because there are so many things that we are coming out from it. And in the realm of the spirit, they have seen it. What do they have to do? They come to us now and they put offenses in us. You don't see yourself being attacking people and yourself doing things in your home, but you don't know what is happening. The person who is doing it is somewhere attached, corner, invisible, but doing it. And you are there fighting yourself. In your home, maybe you are fighting your husband. Your husband is fighting you. You are fighting your children. Your children are fighting you. Your uncles, your cousins. Everywhere is just pandemonium of negativity. And you have seen it. No! Go down on your knees and pray. Pray! Pray! Mm-hmm. Kick out that laziness to pray. Anything that is going to make you not to pray, kick it out of your territory. Kick it out of your territory and take the power and authority of God to move ahead, to move ahead. Nothing will drag you behind. Nothing will take you behind. Nothing will pull you, but you will never push onto the king. The mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Have that power. Have that zeal to pray prayer. To scatter the realm of the spirits in the realm of God. You will see the rays of God calling upon you. You will feel that divine connectivity. When praying, your belly will be moving, and you will see the power of God telling you that, daughter, son, you have to pray. You have to have that connectivity in me. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Have that divine power. That divine power. That force. That is highly unbreakable, untouchable, unstoppable. But rather, you have to move, only keep on going from glory to glory and from strength to strength in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. Feel the power of God as you pray. Feel the power of God as you pray. Feel the power of God as you pray. Amen. Prayer is the master key. Mm-hmm. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the master. Please let me hear your voices, please. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I know some of us, we are still feeling a little bit sleepy, but this is a time of warfare. We have come here for God's business. We have come here to pray. We have come here to have that intimacy with God. We have come here to believe in the things of God. We have not come here for anything but just for that. And when you are coming here, prepare yourself. Prepare yourself. I can see most of you are already ready. Nearly all of you are ready to receive that power of God, to receive Amen. The Holy Spirit. It should be activated Amen. In you. Have that let your spiritual man be uplifted and take down whatever thing that is disturbing your flesh, not to move ahead, but rather take the things that is going to anoint you for you to push forward in the Amen. Mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Not to be your spirit down, but everything that is around you will rather boast up your spirit. As in Psalm 150, the power of the God say what? Make everything around you to praise God. Use every instrument to praise God. Amen. Why? Keep on praising. As you praise, that's how the praises comes also in you. Take out any sorrowful environment around you, any sorrowful things that you are thinking. No, but rather any garment of sorrow, kick it out and put on the garment of joy, blessings, favor in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Amen.
Let that power to pray. Let anything that try to bring us down or any distraction, because most of the time in the place of prayer or trying to connect yourself in the place of prayer, you have a lot of distractors and things that will distract you. But mind you, concentrate, be focused. You should just be like somebody who have closed his eyes, but rather put it just focus to what he's going. Where he's going, that is where he's watching. That is why, how, and the way you have to follow the things of God. Because the things of God are not the things of man. God is not man. God is not man. God is not man. To follow God, you have to be spiritual. And when you are spiritually inclined, that is how you see your spiritual life start changing. And if your spiritual life is changing, it means your physical life also will change.
Amen.
Because we are talking about the footsteps of God, yes, and not about the talking of God. Your lips has no big influence in you, but rather your heart. Because if your heart changes, then even your way of walking, your way of talking, your lips also will be controlled.
Amen.
But if your lips is the one controlling your inner mind, it will not work. But if you rather your inner mind controlling your lips, it's going to work. That is why as Christians, we have to be very careful what we watch, what we listen to, and what we talk. Because those things will rather come to you knowingly or unknowingly. Rather, you need to have that faith in God. You need to have that belief in God. Some people will look at you, oh, how is this man now following the things of God? Yes, it's because God has opened you the way. You have been in blindness, but now you have seen the light. Amen. I have seen the light. The light of God.
I have seen the light of God. Jesus is the light of God. Jesus is the light of God.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Amen.
Everything that will make you to put down your head, for you to stop doing the things of God, tell the thing that no, there is not possible. Your head will stand up to look at the things of God in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Amen.
Your belief, your faith is too much for you for 1 minute to backslide in the things of God. Let that faith of yours keep on increasing in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Amen.
Let us go to Acts 12:4. Please.
The book of Acts.
Heavenly Father, Lord God, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, teach us how to pray. Teach us how to pray, Lord. Teach us how to pray, Lord. Teach us how to pray, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, give us that total connectivity with you. Give us that intimacy. Make us to know you, Lord. Make us to know you, Lord. Make us to know you, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Lord. Take more of us and give us more of you. Take more of us and give us more of you. Take more of us and give us more of you. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen.
I read from King James Version. And when he had apprehended him, he put him in prison and delivered him to four quaternions of soldiers to keep him, intending after Easter to bring him forth to the people. Peter, therefore, was kept in prison, but prayer was made without ceasing. Peter, therefore, was kept in prison, but prayer was made without ceasing of the church unto God for him.
Amen.
People did not go to sleep. He was in prison. He himself didn't sleep. But people in the church, everywhere, they prayed for him. They had that divine connection. You saw what happened with Saul when he was destroying the people of God. And he was going to Damascus. But he was caught on the way with the power of God. And from then on, he turned. And through the connection, he went down to Ananias. That is how it is. He received his baptism and everything. I became now somebody who is instead for God, for Jesus Christ. That is the same thing here. That divine connection. I'm here. People are having their deliverance. People are receiving their prophecy. People are receiving their healing through the name of God, through the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, here in this platform. Testimonies are all over about that. Why? I'm not there where you are, but we serve a God who is omnipresent.
Amen.
Amen.
We serve a God of signs and wonders, a God of miracles, the protocol breaker, the divine changer. That's the God we serve. And if you believe in him, you have faith in him, he must show you his signs and wonders. He must be there for you. As he rightly said in Psalm 91, because you have shown his love. You have shown love towards God. And you have known his name. He's going to honor you. He's going to be with you in times of trouble. And he's going to satisfy you by giving you his salvation. Why? Because you have known him. You have known his name. There's nobody who can know God and know God diligently and you do not receive what he is having for you. Amen. No, it's not possible. It's not possible. It's not possible. Connect yourself and collect what is for you with that connectivity, divine connectivity. Do not connect in the things of God with physical realm. No, realm of the spirit. We are serving a spiritual God, a spiritual being, our Father. So for you to be highly connected, you have to be in the spirit.
Amen.
And there should be no doubt in you. What is it? Have your connection. What happened here? Peter, therefore, was kept in prison, but prayer was made without ceasing of the church unto God for him. It means what? Christians came together all over praying for his release. And he himself was praying. So there was that divine connection roaming. Mm-hmm. Unknowingly to the people in the prison. But he knows because he had that connection.
Mm-hmm.
That is how we have to be in our own selves. Wherever we are, that's why I'm saying, thank God for yourself. Know how to pray for yourself. Have that personal relationship with God. Be yourself pastor. Be yourself apostle. Be yourself prophet and prophetess. Be yourself teachers. Be yourself everything as concerns God. Evangelist. Because any place you are, in terms of trouble, we connect. And those people who are not there with you, but they are there with you physical and spiritually. Because why? They are there with you spiritually in the sense that they are praying and their prayers have their connection.
Amen.
That's why at times you will go to bed and you are praying. You will see what will happen. Maybe you see the man of God with you praying, or you see the man of God doing something to you. That is how it is. Why? Because you have gone into the realm and the angels are highly alerted. The angels are up to see that you achieve what you want to achieve. Because why? You have surrendered yourself. You have given yourself to God. And you are serving God diligently. How was Peter praying? And how the church was praying? Prayer without ceasing unto the church of the church unto God for him. They were praying for him in the churches. For him, intercessors have to rise to pray for Peter, for God to listen. And how did they pray? Without ceasing. That is why we are talking about prayer. If you are praying, you are in the altar of prayer. What do you have to be? You have to be consistent in prayers, consistent in the things of God. That consistency shows up at any moment. Yes. God is not man. Believe in God. Have faith in God and you will see the results. You can doubt the means, but you will never doubt the results because the results are there. But the means and the testimonies will make you to know who is God. And when Herod would have brought him forth, The same night, Peter was sleeping between two soldiers, bound with two chains, and the keepers before the door kept the prison. And behold, angel of the Lord came upon him. The angel of the Lord came upon him. Why? Connectivity. The people in the church were praying. Peter himself was praying. And the angel of the Lord had to be released. Why released? Because spiritually, his spirit has been lifted. His spirit man is up. He's having that divine connectivity. That is what happens in the place of prayer. In the place of prayer, when you pray and pray well, continuous prayer without ceasing, your harvest will come. And your harvest will come without even you knowing it. Why? Because you are there diligently doing the things of God. You are there wholeheartedly putting your things in the place of God.
Amen.
Prayer without ceasing. You don't receive prophecy and go and sleep with it. No. You receive prophecy, positive prophecy, for it to come and pass. You have to pray and fast for it. Because there are not all the prayers, not all the prophecy will come only with prayer. There are some you have to fast. There are some you have to sacrifice. Yes. For it. You can go to a church and be sweeping. That is a sacrifice you are doing physically. You can buy something and support the work of God. That is your sacrifice. That you are doing. That is the fear that we have to have. Anything that we do in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you have to do it diligently, and you have to put yourself in the place with the spirits. Why the angel is coming? Because of divine connection. That is why the angel of the Lord is appearing. That is what is happening with some of us. At times when we are in situations, we see ourselves coming out of it. Maybe you saw a man of God in your dream. You see something that was tend to be something different, the thing came now to be different. That is it. And behold, the angel of the Lord came upon him, and a light shined in the prison. A light shined in the prison. And he smote Peter on the side and raised him up, saying, "Arise up quickly." And his chains fell off from his hands. Divine power, divine connection. There is nothing too hard for our God to do. There is no boundaries. There is nowhere that you say God will not reach. Mm-mm. There is nothing that you will say he will not do. Mm-mm. Have that connectivity. Believe. Have faith. And where is it coming? The place of prayer. The place of prayer. Anything that is in your heart disturbing you not to pray well, throw that thing away before coming to pray. So that after prayer, you will not meet the thing again. Amen. Even the thing wants to come, the thing is going to bounce. Because why? You will be uplifted, spiritually uplifted. And your spirit Amen. Will not be taking you to those worldly things again. Your spirit will be taking you to things that will glorify the name of God. Things that will be seeking for your salvation. Things that will be moving you and grooving you for you to know more about God. Begging the Holy Spirit, who is our comforter and our teacher, to teach you more. Anything that will come to disturb your heart, to make you to feel bad, you kick it aside. Because why? Most of the times, if we are achieving good things, that's when you will see certain spirit will come and enter us. Before you know, you'll be reacting and you will do certain things that you will start regretting after. Things that you couldn't have done them, but you are doing it. Why? Because a spirit entered you. And as a spiritual man, you're supposed to dictate it. And put your knees down in the place of prayer. Go to your altar and pray. Have that divine connectivity with God to overcome it. Overcomers are mostly produced overnight in the place of prayer. Yes? Because midnight prayer, very important, very strong. That's when destinies have been exchanged. If your destiny has been exchanged before, it will not exchange again in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Amen.
I cover the destiny of everybody with the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
I cover the destiny of everybody with the blood of Jesus.
Blood of
Jesus. Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Jesus.
Peter on the side and raised him up, saying, "Arise up quickly," and his chains fell off from his hands. And the angel said unto him, "Gird thyself and bind on thy sandals." And so he did. What is that? Instructions. Instructions. The angel is saying, do this, put on your sandals, do this, and that is not what is following. The things of God are to be obeyed. Trust in the things and obey. Trust and obey. There is no that is it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is it. We need to move closer and closer to God. How do we go? By trusting in Him and obeying Him. That is all. The more you trust in the things of God, the more you obey, the more you see yourself walking without facing difficulties. The more you see yourself, things are just opening onto you. You'll be asking, oh, what is happening? No, it's happening because you were in that place of prayer.
That's
it's happening
true.
Because you put yourself into prayer, and not only prayer, but you pray diligently. And because you put everything behind of you, and you focus on the things of God. Seek ye the kingdom of God, and any other thing will be added to you. Not only added, but added abundantly.
Amen.
That is it. Yes.
Amen.
Yes. Because you put your that is it. And not only prayer, but you pray diligently. And because you put everything behind of you, and you focus on the things of God.
Somebody have put the life program.
Added to you. Not only added, but added abundantly.
Amen.
So that is how it is. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Pakasha rakata nikisikita pakata rokuto nikisikita pakata. Shakata rokuto nikisikita pakata rakata nikisikita pakata rokuto nikite. Shekite kisa pakata.
And he went out and followed him, and wist not that it was true which was done by the angel, but thought he saw a vision. This is what is happening at times. The things of the spirit are different from that of man. Spiritual things remain spiritual. Physical things remain physical. That is what is happening here. The angel of the Lord came and was doing all these things, but he was thinking that he was in a vision. But when he got up, he saw that these things were real. That is why at times we sleep and we see that something has happened to somebody or to us. And when we get up in the morning, we actually see it. We actually see it manifesting. If not that time, but it came to manifest. We have seen so many times a prophecy came and somebody say, no, I don't know that. I don't know. But you want to see the person will be coming back giving testimony. See, what the man of God told me is the thing I experienced. So that is how it is. That is the life we are living.
Amen.
That is the life we are living. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Santo and amen.
When they were cast, the first and the second word, they came unto the iron gates that leadeth unto the city, which opened to them of his own accord. On his own accord.
Man.
And they went out and passed on through one street, and forthwith the angel departed from him. The angels have come and done his work to release him from prison. After releasing from prison, he goes now out of the gate of the prison and everything, and allowed him, and the angel now departed from him. Why? Assignment accomplished.
Amen.
That is what is happening with us. At times, you don't know who is coming into your life. Destiny helpers are being controlled by God to fall into you. Heavenly Father, any destiny helper so assigned to us, let them locate us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
See what is happening. After all being released in the prison, he was also left there in the prison and went. No, he took it out of the iron gates. Out of the iron gates. That is what is happening with us. There are so many of us, our gates have been closed. You see yourself in a vision or in a dream or in a revelation that God is showing you. You are out of his house. Then you want to go out now. You see a fence. And how can you go out of it? You are seeing yourself, that thing is you are seeing like a vision or like a dream. It is not. It is what is happening in your real life. You have to pray. It's a prayer point. Oh Lord, open our gates for us.
Amen.
Oh Lord, open our gates for us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Let us pray, pray, pray. Oh Lord, open our gates for us.
Open our gates
for us.
Open our gates, oh Father.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Whatever it does, let us open in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Open our gates for us, Lord. Oh Lord, send the angels for us. Send the angels for us when they come. Or send the angels after us, Lord. Send the angels. The angels come after us, Lord. Open our gates, Lord. Give us that divine connectivity. Give us that divine connectivity. Give us that divine connectivity. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The mighty name of Jesus Christ. The mighty name of Jesus Christ. Give us that divine connectivity. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Pakasharo kutoniki. Sikita pakatana. Ekishikita pakasharo kutoniki. Heavenly Father, move our gates. Any negative thing that we might have dread, oh Heavenly Father, I cancel it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I cancel it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I cancel it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Open our gates, Lord. Open our gates, Lord. Open our gates, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Open our gates. Open our gates. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Open our gates, Lord. Open our gates, Lord. And grant us your peace in Jesus' mighty
Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for giving us that divine connectivity. Thank you for opening our gates, Lord. Thank you for breaking any barrier that has been in front of us.
Amen.
The mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord. Sister Bibian. Sister Bibian. Sister Bibian, where are you, please? I'm not seeing you. Unmute yourself, please. Sister Bibian, please unmute yourself. Are you hearing me?
I can hear you now. I was at the I was using my AirPods. That's why.
Okay. I was doubting that what is happening. I'm not seeing you, please.
I'm here.
Okay. Yeah, when I was when we're praying and interceding for the things of God and Peter, what just came to me was you. That's what happened to Peter. That is what is happening to you. It is a season that is that divine connection.
Amen.
That breaking of all type of spirits that are trying to block you, Amen. That you have got out of it.
Amen.
And the power of God upon you very heavily.
Amen.
Very heavily. The power of God is on you. Amen. Very heavily, as I'm speaking like this.
Amen.
From your head to the sole of your feet, all over.
Amen.
Please hold your gadget well. Cannot see you.
Amen.
Yes. It's very powerful. It's very powerful.
Amen.
Can you just tell us what is your recent experience, the second experience and the third experience? Because I think the first experience, so many of us, I think nearly everybody in the podium knows about it, but the second and the third. What the message that the Spirit of God is leading you, is telling you.
Yes, some of them I can remember. I thank God that the record, some I can't remember.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah.
All I want to just say that I thank God out of fire, because, you know, sometimes it's like you are sick, but you don't know what is going on with you inside you.
I know well in the camera, sister. Okay, now I see you.
Sometimes you feel like you are sick. You go to the doctor, but you don't know what is your problem. That's how I was feeling for years. Like something is like in me. Spirit is like me, but it can't come out. I'm trying, but it can't come out. When I joined this hotel fire, then... From that day, the first day I came, as I said before, I feel like I was in different place. And the next day I connected, that's where the whole thing started. I was like driving my car, the Holy Spirit will just connect with me. I start to speak and the Holy Spirit will tell me to record or write. But at that point, when I'm not like in the position that I have something to write, I'll just pick up my phone. I start to record so many things that I don't know, and he would tell me, send it to my prophet, who is my spiritual father. He said that it connects me with him because he knows that he the one who connects me to him, is my spiritual father.
Oh, he tells the name, please.
What prophet? The prophet was.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
He's the one who connects me to him. He giving me message to tell him message about my personal life, things that I have to do, things that he have to do, even the way that when he comes here, he have to pray for me. So many details that I was just, at one point I was, am I dreaming? So every time I call him, he would tell me something that the Holy Spirit really told me. So that confirmed me that, oh, this have to be my spiritual father, as the Lord said. So and be account with so many messages since there that I just thank God, and I'm advising everyone that we should connect in this altar of fire, because the last one he told me is that this altar of fire is not ordinary altar of fire.
Amen.
There's something special on this altar of fire that we have to connect, and we need to be happy or lucky, because it will be on time that we'll find our prophet will not have it, because he will be busy. So we need to grab him now that we have the opportunity to see him or to talk to him, because it will be time that you book appointment for weeks before we can see him.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. There are so many points that I actually forgot, but I just thank God, because at one point I was scared that can this happen to someone that I'm in the kitchen. I came back from work. I say, oh, I'm not cooking today. Let me do just my salad for us to eat tonight. Then the Holy Spirit will just enter me and say, take your phone, record this. I start to speak. We will talk about the last one. He talked about Sister Colette. He talked about Pastor. He talked about me, myself. I was told, like, what is going on here? But I know that it's God.
Amen.
God.
Amen.
God is good. And every one of us, we have in us, so we just have to connect to ourselves, and it will come out.
Amen.
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 Glory to Jesus.
That's what sister is saying. It's not what I told her, but it's about her encounter.
Wow.
About the encounter that she got, angelic encounter. Divine encounter, and has gotten messages after encountering the God of this altar. And most of the time when she's meeting me to tell me the things that divine assignment that she has gotten an encounter, I will be telling her. So she's just saying what is happening. That is how.
Amen.
Yes, that is how God works.
Hallelujah.
You see, she is a woman of God. She has a calling, a prophetic calling. She's a prophetess. But for long, it has been down. God connected her. God is the one who brought her here with the connection.
Amen.
And when she even came, there are things that came to fight her.
Yes.
Spirits that have been keeping her came to fight her.
Yeah.
Yes, being a spiritual man, when you're a spiritual somebody, you don't look at human, you don't look at flesh. That is one of the things that you have to know. You don't look at flesh, but you look at what is going to praise the name of God.
Amen.
Where the glory of God will come from. That's where
you go.
Because you are living because of his mercy. Then when you see what he is doing and he has been doing, your own is to glorify his name.
Amen.
And how can somebody take away the glory of God? It's not possible. No, you will stand there. That is why he said, Jesus Christ said, Go and sell your garment and buy sword. Yes. We are all soldiers. If you know you don't have one, sell your garment and buy one.
Amen.
Amen. Glory.
So for anything that is going to praise the name of the Lord, what is going to glorify the name of the Lord, you don't play with it. You stand there. Because that is what you are. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Stand with that power of God. There's an anointing moving on now. Anointing moving on. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Keep on moving. The mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
When Sister Bibia was connected here, immediately she was open. The Spirit of God said, activate her. And she was activated immediately by the Spirit of God, by God Himself.
Yes, we monitor it.
Now she has that power. She has that opening. Her, what has been disturbing her inside, they are all going out. We're running. Why? Because Holy Spirit fire dwells in her fully.
Amen.
Amen.
Darkness and light can never comprehend. That is it.
Also, I just want to add something, because when God wants to do something, always trace the roads, because this for so many churches that this never happened, and God connected me with my sister Elizabeth to come on the altar of fire and to be delivered, because I call that I'm in deliver now.
Amen.
We are all together here. We need to connect people on this altar of fire, because let us together will soul. Because
amen.
Sister Elizabeth, may God bless you, because you connected me on this one. That's what God actually used you to connect me on this altar. So we have to connect people on this altar, because there's something special on this altar.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord. Yeah, Mama Ia, do you have something to say? I'm seeing your hand up, please.
Thank you, Prophet, and greetings, everybody.
Greetings.
I just want to add more to what Sister Vivian said. There's something you call angelic encounters. This is something where you encounter it. Nobody can talk you out of God.
Jesus.
In the book of Hebrews, God said, we're not going to preach now like baby preachers that drink. He said, oh, you keep drinking milk, preaching about repentance and this. It is like baby preacher. What are we doing now? We are searching for those souls that have tasted Christ and backslided. We are looking for them, and we are connecting them back to God. Those lost sheep, those are the ones we are going for. Amen. What Sister Bibian was saying is that when Saul encountered God, nobody can talk him away from God. His faith stand firm. My faith is standing firm today, not because somebody preached to me. No. Because I bore witness on the calling of our prophets.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit bore witness to Jesus Christ. When John the Baptist saw Jesus Christ, there was something that made him to know that was Jesus Christ. that connectivity, that spiritual exposure.
Oh,
you cannot doubt. See, that is just what that be blessed encounter. It's like Sister Colette, when she saw me, when I came to visit her, she saw the dove on my head.
Yes.
It's something that God is going to make for somebody with a spiritual eye, somebody with an open mind to see. Because he says that even stone, he can use them to praise him. We are all in this altar. God said, gone are those days I wrote my laws on tablets. My laws are being written in your hearts. I dwell in your hearts. So God dwells in each and every one of us. How are we activating that call of God in you? How are we activating that power in you? This altar, I always say it. If God ministers to you, there are so many people in this altar that have encountered the God of this altar. God have shown them that he is here. It's not an ordinary altar. If you listen to Sister Bibian encounters about our prophet, about our man of God, we are all operating because he said that he is raising new brand of prophets.
Jesus.
He is raising them because the older ones are going. So God is in the purpose. You know, when Moses died, the journey of the children of Israel to get to the promised land did not end. God raised Joshua. So that is what God is doing. His plan never ends. If you want to get to a place, get there. Amen. So when we are in this altar, we open ourselves to this grace, to the God of this altar. My dear sisters and brother, you will see God in his majesty.
Amen.
You are going to encounter him. Amen.
Amen.
I don't want to take much of your time. I only want to testify also to add to what Sister Bibian is saying. And I believe also Sister Gina also have encountered it when he's praying and saw the rainbow. And also, I think our minister Gina also, the first time she joined this altar, she said when she saw the man of God, she saw fire. She saw dew coming out from his mouth. I mean, God opened his spiritual eye to see the altar that he's been connected to. So we should be spiritual, as the prophet always says. Let's be spiritual to connect. In this altar, we are to build fire brand women of God and men of God. We are going to build new generation of women that have power. Because without power, you cannot save God without power. In this generation, if you are saving God without power, it's an error. Amen.
Amen.
So thank you. I don't want to take it. Thank you, Prophet. Thank you so much. And I greet your grace. Thank you for allowing me to speak. I so appreciate this moment. And God bless us all for connecting in Jesus' name. Let us
Amen. Yeah.
Sister Colette, your hand was up. Oh.
Yes, Prophet. I don't know. I greet you, Prophet. I greet your grace. I greet everybody. I mean, listening to Sister Bibian, oh my God. These are the kind of things, just the few that I understand. These are the kind of things when it happens.
Don't give me one moment. There's an impartation, there's a power, there's a glory of Sister Bibian. Now let it complete.
Amen.
But, Heavenly Father. Utter Lord.
I connect.
Power kata no kusidikita pakata rakata. The power of God lie on you now. The power of God lie on you now. Pakasara koto ni kisikita pakata. Take it. Kita pakata rakata. Tama kata ro koto ni kisikita. We serve a living God. We serve a powerful God. Take it. Take it. Open your mouth and release the message. Open your mouth and release that message now. Thank you, Lord. Come on, all over now. Let the power fall. Let the power fall. Let the anointing of God fall. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let the anointing of God fall. Let the anointing of God fall. Feel that divine presence of God. Feel that divine presence of God. Connect yourself. Connect yourself. Connect yourself. Connect yourself in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Connect yourself. I scatter those kings. Any blockage, Lord God, scatter them. Enlarge our coast, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Cover our prayers with the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
I cover our prophetic declarations with the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Just well.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you,
Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your divine presence, Lord. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your presence, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for your presence.
Thank you, Lord.
You are the only one who can do. No one else can do. Only you can say what no one can say, Jehovah.
Only you can do. Only you can do what no one can do, Jehovah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Sister Colette, just continue. There is something that I want to say with Sister Doris. Sister Colette, continue, please.
Thank you, Prophet. Thank you, Prophet. Thank you. What I was just going to add into what Sister Bibian just told us, and from the little that I understand, is that
we do not see you well, Sister Colette.
I said, what I can add.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah, okay. What I can add to what Sister Bibian has just told us is that these are the kind of things or messages, encounters, when it happens to more populated ministries, we almost start to go like they have paid that person. Because if I were not here, to be honest, and if my faith was not this, I've not built my faith the way I am, is something that someone with a carnal mind who is not more spiritual could say they have paid Sister Bibian, because the kind of she just joined. That would be the first question. As she just joined us, she's not been here up to a month or two. Then the enemies wanted to fight her, and then all of a sudden she's getting this encounter. These are the kind of stories that sometimes now it makes me to understand what the men of God, what other ministries they go through. Because it's so easy for someone to say, oh, maybe because she wanted to make, she wasn't confident or she was not comfortable with what was happening, they have paid her. And now she's come back now to fix the name of the ministry by saying all these things. So what am I saying? I'm trying to open our eyes and ears so that in the next future, in the nearest future, when the ministry will go large, we can use this example. Because stories will start to come up, people will always find something to say. At least we can reflect on this. because the level that the Holy Spirit or God has been using her and is still using her, bringing this kind of messages, I mean, it's like, I mean, it can only be God. So we just thank God for God. Like you are more to say, no man can be God, and man cannot be God. Amen.
God is not man.
Yeah. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It is well. We give him all the glory. All glory belongs to him. Him alone.
Amen.
Let him share his glory with somebody. Sister Doris.
Yes, Prophet. Yes, Prophet.
Are you at work?
No, I put
because you are not on video, please.
Okay, I put up the light because the child was sleeping.
Okay. But I would like to that you go on video, please.
Let me put it on, Prophet.
Okay. I was praying. The Lord said I should tell you. You are a worship minister.
Amen.
Amen.
And this thing has been happening to you, but you don't know. You have been having songs in the realm of the spirit. Songs have been falling on you. Songs have been falling on you. Not now, long.
Jesus.
But maybe you don't know. That is where you belong to.
Amen.
That is where you belong to.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, a worship minister.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. Amen.
You can at any moment meditate, songs will be coming to you.
Amen.
Some of the songs, you know how they're coming.
Amen.
You don't even know how they're coming. But you are thinking that you just like songs or you just like socialism. Mm-mm. That is where you belong to sing
Amen.
For God.
Amen.
Sing for God.
Amen.
That is your part in the ministry, to sing Amen. For God.
Amen.
Yes. Amen. Praise your voice, your vocal cavities for God.
Amen.
Yes. He gave you that voice to sing for him.
When Sister Bibiana finished talking, and then we were praying. When you were praying for us. Can you hear me?
I'm hearing you. We are hearing you.
Yeah.
When Sister Bibiana finished talking, and then when you were praying and asking the Holy Spirit to touch everyone, I don't know. I don't know what was happening to me. I just want to cry. But as I'm crying, I have a song that I wanted to sing. I was still looking for the opportunity. So something just
like to pull my hand. Are you people hearing what I'm saying?
Hallelujah!
Are you people hearing what I'm saying?
Yes,
that's what the God said to me, as you make her to know that is what she has, and she has never known that she's a Lord worship minister.
So each time somebody is saying something, there is a song that I know that concerns what he's saying. So when Sister Juliana was talking, I was talking to myself that I'm waiting for God to talk to me, and this is the song that I wanted to sing. If you can listen,
Amen.
I am Amen. A soldier in the battlefield,
Amen.
Waiting to hear the voice of my commander. Jesus, if you call my name,
I will answer.
Hallelujah.
Let me just sing, please. Jesus, if you call my name, Hallelujah. I am a soldier in the battlefield, waiting to hear the voice of my commander. Jesus is calling my name. Jesus, if you call my name, I will answer a billion times.
Hallelujah.
Who is calling my name?
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you, Hallelujah. Oh, my name, I will answer
Hallelujah.
So I was crying to God that I'm listening and I'm waiting for him. I know if he calls my name, I'm ready to answer. That's what I was just thinking, and that song was coming into my head. Thank you, Prophet. Hallelujah. For the opportunity, thank you for the grace over your life.
And he reveals to redeem.
Amen.
Revelation come to redemption in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Yeah.
So that is who. Have you ever gotten this urge that to sing, to do things, and you have even the vision and dream?
I just like me to sing, even if I'm in any place when they're talking about God or they are giving a message. There's always a song that I know that I've heard, like one of these songs,
yes,
that I want to sing to match that message, but maybe I don't have opportunity. Sometimes I'm afraid to sing because I don't have a good voice. I may miss some words along the way because maybe I don't know the song completely, but there's always a song that match a message that's coming to me.
Yes, that's how it is. It's a gift. It's something that is your calling. That is your calling to praise God. And your local church that you are going, please try to attach yourself with the choir. Yes, please try to attach yourself with the choir. It's important.
Amen.
It's important. Yes, there are so many things that have been blocking, and through that, God will open you so many things. You will see it. You come back here and testify.
Amen.
Yes, come back here and testify. That's how it is.
Amen.
I cover you with the blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
I cover you with the blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
Cover you with the blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
It is well.
Amen.
It is well.
Please, Prophet, I so want to announce. If you are not following the Prophet Facebook page, please, members of Divine Favor Ministry Praying Platform, let us try to follow our Prophet on his Facebook. Just click follow on the Facebook. Each and every one of us, we are more than 100 on this platform. And we can also invite our loved ones to just click follow. So that in case one day the Spirit will lead Prophet to go live on Facebook, we'll be alerted. We'll know that Prophet is live. Even on the YouTube, our YouTube, we are 62 now, I think so, but we are more than that. So we should just try to click subscribe so that when Prophet is live on YouTube, we'll all have this notification. Can just see our phone will just pop at that prophet. So the Holy Spirit will be using prophets in different ways. He might just sleep and get up and just start finding himself in Facebook talking. So we should not miss any of these opportunities. Amen. Amen. And now also the prophet just opened a new TikTok. It's just new. I think it's yesterday. We can also follow him, Prophet Owasi. It's also the same name, Prophet Owasi on YouTube.
I'm a
YouTube,
TikTok fan.
Owasi on TikTok, Prophet Owasi on Facebook. We should just follow the prophet
Thank you, Mama, for that.
Thank you, Mama Prophet.
I put the power upon Sister Bibian. Let God continue to rise on with you. Let God continue to put His power on you. Let His power keep on falling on you. And the right hand of man is the right hand of God. As my right hand stretches, let the power of my right hand come to your right hand now.
Amen.
Let it come now. Amen. I say now.
Amen.
Let those fingers start moving now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let those fingers start moving now. Let the power of God fall there now. The mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let the power of God move there now. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Total activation of your spiritual power. Total activation of your calling. I activate the right hand. To do the work of God. I activate that right hand now. Do the work of God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for your signs and wonders, for your presence in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
Name must be glorified.
Amen.
Have a living God.
Amen.
God is not man. God is not man. God is not man.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. I cover you with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Prophet. Thank you.
Yeah, it is well. God bless you.
Amen.
God bless you. Takatarakotoni kisikita pakata, pakasharokotoni kisikita, pakarikite kisa pakata no kusoni kita pakasana kata, pakasarokotoni kisikita pakata, pakasarokotoni kisikite, kisikita pakasano koto, ukusorokotoni kisikita pakata, pakasarakata ni kisikita pakata no koto, ukusorokotoni kisikita pakata, pakasarakata ni kisikita pakata, in the mighty name of Jesus. 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 Mighty name.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Yeah, Sister Nelly, please.
Yes, Prophet. I have a testimony.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
So I want to testify about my health. It was last Tuesday. I was at home and I feel like somebody strangled me. So it was difficult to me to breathe. And I called Mama Anna to have an appointment with Prophet, so Prophet can pray on me. And I pray with Prophet and my husband, it was a spirit, one of the person in my family that's trying to kill me since it's many years now. And she's using my star to have money. So she confessed, and the Prophet prayed on me. She released everything that she stole in my life. And after the prayer, since that time, and I didn't have that one again. So that day, the first day she came, it was her, and the second day it was the chief of their meeting, the family meeting that they used to do. So they came together, and the Prophet delivered me for that. And since that time, so I'm feel okay.
Hallelujah.
Thank you to God and thank you to Prophet for the time that it takes to deliver us, because that is the way that sometimes somebody can just stay and they listen that is dead. You see somebody is well, and the hour after, they just say that the person is dead, because I was at home alone and I was strong. I took some 180. I was just saying, I'm not dying. I'm not dying. I mean, let me say this one in French. Je vais pas mourir, mais je vivrai. Je ne mourrai pas, mais je vivrai. Je raconterai les œuvres de l'Éternel dans ma vie. Je ne mourrai pas, je vivrai. Donc, I was saying that, waiting that I can have a prophet online so he can pray with me, because it was too hard. I was feeling that I'm going to die, so it was heavy, and I'm just confessing that, waiting that I can have him on phone to pray. So I want to thank God.
Hallelujah. Come on. Thank you, Prophet, for your availability. Thank you, Prophet. We appreciate your availability. We appreciate your
availability.
Come on, everybody. Come on.
What Sister Nelly is talking is not something easy, but you know, God is not man.
Amen.
God is God. Yes, because when I was called, Sister Anna actually called me and said, Prophet, it is an emergency. It is an emergency. That's what she said. I said, okay. I said, well, we say for Sister Nelly and Emperor calling. I said, what? So he said, yes. Okay. I had to intervene immediately. And when I went there, immediately the spirit heard my voice. She started manifesting. It was not small manifestation. No. That aunt was speaking through her. So many things, and the ant was being defeated. And the ant went, now they are in a group. I was, the Spirit of God was leading me, say, Famla, and the chief of it, the chief, they have gone with her so many places. For 12 years, they have been punishing her for 12 years. That's what they were confessing. It was just like video. So you are watching a general film.
Since I have 12 years old, so it's more than
yes. 12 years. Yes, since she was 12. Since she was 12, they have been there. I asked that their chief. I said, now you are coming to disturb this lady. Why are you disturbing her? He said, because they are giving her percentage. Each time they operate, he has a percent. I said, what percent? He said, 30%. I said, of what? He said, of her wealth, of her star, everything that they are using. That's what he said, though. Her own aunt, the mother's sister, all with the name, all, because of security reasons, we cannot just release name. All the name was there. Even that chief, I asked him. He said, yes, we cannot allow her to go because she has also eaten from our side. I said, what shall she eat? He said, for him, he has given two of his sons. This is what I'm telling you all.
Great boss.
He has given two of his sons. I said, where is your market? What are you doing? He said, no, he's having a supermarket. He's having Kenkaleri in Kamara. I said, where? He said, in Buddha. He said, in the market. I said, what are the names of your son? He told me the names of the son. But for security reasons, you cannot just say it. Yes, clearly. I said, so you get those sons, now how are you feeling? He said, he's feeling fine because he wanted money and he got the money. Two sons, oh, two. What I'm talking, we can just see, we have the video is there, the statement, everything is there. One day, I think we'll see part of it, we'll know what we're talking about. That is why this world, the life we are living is spiritual.
Oh, thank you, Father.
To live well, you have to
yes. Shall flow river of living water.
Amen. I want to add that it was
rivers of living water.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Yes, Sister Nelly.
We did not get her, Sister Nelly.
Yes, I was just saying that on that day, she was confessing that I'm not supposed to pass that midnight. So I was supposed to
kill you.
Yes.
Yes, she was supposed to die that time. yesterday.
Yes. He came with the chief, that chief that day, and said that she's supposed to die that night because the deliverance that Sister Nelly received, she has to go and die. So for her to die, they gathered themselves. They went to two different witch doctors. And she has been, that's why she was feeling that she wants to suffocate, because they tied her neck, they tied a cord on a tree. But tying that tree, they were in the spirit, the realm of the spirit, they were tying the neck of Sister Nelly. That's why she was feeling neck and she could not breathe. That's why she was calling before Sister Anna got to me. And she confessed everything. And she said, how much did you pay the native doctor? She said she paid 45,000 CFA. This is what we are going through. This world is spiritual. That's why you see when spiritual things are coming like this, there are certain people who do not know, they will argue instead of to learn. And those very things will follow them one day.
And appreciate God.
Yes, because God is not man. We give him all the glory. He's the only one who can do it. He's the one who reveals. He's the one who redeems. How can you say, tell somebody that you are supposed to die? They are just waiting. The chief came so that they should just wait at 12 midnight. They kill her and they take the soul away, and the body will be there. You see how people just lost their life. And she was crying, you know, serious crying through her. That, oh, I'm going to die now. I'm going to die now. What am I going to do with my children? So I asked her, so you have your own children. Why do you not go and do this thing to your own children? You are doing it to someone. Yeah, because she's very bright. She's a star in the family. I don't want her to be bright more than my children. I'm telling you, this is the way we are living today. This is the way we are living today. Believe in God. Have faith in God.
Amen.
That's it. Amen. Because we are not always the gap we are sitting here, not only for ourselves, but for our family, our loved ones, our children, and even for the unborn one, because what we are doing now, we are destroying those evil foundations that we might have grown into it, but now we are destroying them so that we can stand in the things of God. By aligning ourselves with the things of God.
And I want to say that when I joined this group at the beginning, Prophet was saying that my own problem is coming from my side, so it's around, it's not far from me.
Yes,
God just confirm everything. God just reveal everything.
Yes,
hiding behind me.
Yes, thank you. Yes, the first day I saw her, that's what I told her directly. I said, Madam, your problem is ancestral for us and your own family. That's where your problem is coming from. Nobody is following you. If you can fight your family, which is at all difficult because they are claiming, you have, everybody family is claiming that legal power. Why? Because of DNA, blood relationship. You might have not seen some of them. You don't even know some of them, but because they have blood with you, they come with that legal tendency to come and put you down. That's why you must fight. And while fighting them, even those who are in the grave, they will all come up. Yes. Someone told me, oh, because of you, we have come to her. We have seen the power that you want to take her from us. That's why I've come out from the grave to come and fight you.
Yes, when we were praying with Prophet, now it was ancestral spirit, because I have many attacks when I'm sleeping. Sometimes they come and hurt me on the leg, and when I get up I can't walk. Sometimes they come and hurt me when I feel pain. So it's 2 days now that I slept and I was fighting with one person that I didn't know, and the person hit my breast. And the second day I was losing a lot of blood. So when I start to narrate the dream to the prophet, so he start to pray. It was today, this evening. So it's that ancestral spirit that is tormenting me like this. And she's come, I don't even know the person. I don't know, because she said that she related to my grandfather. So she was claiming that I'm coming from them. Blood Is it blood relationship and
blood relationship DNA? That's what he said. That you are the next, you are the next person to serve the idol in the family. Who are you to refuse? Who are you to be going to serve that man that you are saying, your father? That's what he was saying. That you must. That I say, why has he come? He said, yes, in the realm of the spirit, he saw me. But because of me, he has to leave the grave to come, because I'm trying to take you away from them. So he has come to fight me. That's what he was saying. Clearly, it's like we are watching a drama or a film going on. This is a spiritual world.
And the prophet was attacked physically today.
Yes. And I was attacked. I said, that's why people came in the morning for me. He said, yes. I said, but people are very small, because who? The God is in me. It's more than you, 1 million. He who called me to do his work, I'm doing his work, not my work. Amen. I didn't call myself to be doing what I'm doing. He called me to do it.
Amen.
So you can't come after me and you will go free. You will not go free.
You die.
Because I'm somebody's assignment. And it's who? Yes. The sovereign God. Almighty God. That's what I'm doing. I didn't go to a theology school to come and be preaching or come and do anything. No. I was sitting here very quiet in my house with my children.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
So that's how it is.
To thank God for my deliverance and thank the prophet who is available for us and the prayer. Because like I say, you can have a problem like this and you don't have somebody to help you.
So
what I thank God is for, even the teaching that the prophet is giving, is enlighten us to know many things. We that we have call, and sometimes we don't even understand what's happening with our life. Because I passed many days, I didn't understand. I have many things that is happening with my life. I don't understand. Even this generational, generational?
Yeah, generational problem, yeah. Mm-hmm. Problem. Ancestral problem, yeah.
Yes, because today they pray on you, you have headache, tomorrow you are sick, and each time you don't have health, you are struggling. Since I was a child, I didn't even understand what's happening with me. It started when my father died, because before, when my father was alive, so the things I was fine, but immediately when he died, things just changed. I don't even remember what it is. I just know that it's a lot of problem, battle from battle. So, and you don't understand what you made. Sometimes you confess, you keep in confess. If it's, you know, if it's this one, you don't know what's happening with you. So it's now that I understand really what is happening with my life. Because before, I was just tormented. I was just discouraged. I don't even know what to do again, because I was praying until I was tired.
We'll give him all the glory. He's the one doing it. He's the one revealing it. It's not me. I have no power. I have nothing to do. He's the one. That's why we give him back all the glory. All glory belongs to him.
God will glorify you.
His name must be praised. His name must be worshipped. Glorify him.
Amen.
Amen. I cover your deliverance in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, and let your deliverance be permanent in Jesus' mighty name. I cover you with the blood of Jesus. I cover you with the blood of Jesus. I cover everybody attached to this, on this altar. Everybody attached to this altar, I cover you with the blood of Jesus. And your family, your children, your loved ones, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, in Jesus' mighty name.
I just want to keep in my spirit. I'm seeing 122 angels at the moment.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That's it. Oh God. Your spiritual eyes will keep on opening. I told you. Your spiritual eyes will keep on opening.
Oh Lord, angels of this altar.
That's it. You're connected to the angels of this altar, the ascending and descending angels.
Amen.
Connected. Be connected. Be connected. Be connected. I told many of you, when you are praying here, go into spiritual.
I'm connected.
Most of the things that we do experience, most of the things that we do experience here will be spiritual. Because I believe in the realm of the spirit. Anything that is spiritual, that's where I believe too. Because if you are more spiritual, physical things will align and follow you easily. Yes.
And the prophet, And I don't know if it's related directly to Mama Anna or is Mama Anna. I'm seeing accident around her. I don't know if it's her or it's direct. I don't know. But I'm just seeing.
Let's pray for the spirit of accident in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Amen.
Let's pray for the spirit of accident.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
What I'm telling you, when she, I told her that you are having a prophetic calling. I said you are a prophetess. I told her, so you have a calling of God. You are a prophetess. And I said, don't worry. As you are attached to this place, God is going to use me to activate you.
Hallelujah.
What is happening today? Are you not seeing what is happening today?
Women of fire. Women of fire.
Connect.
Amen.
Connect.
Amen. God, may God reveal himself to everyone on this platform.
Amen.
God reveal himself to us. God will gather us to his assignment in our life.
And sacrifice. Prayer, fasting, sacrifice. You get support. Why? Diligently. Do not stand and be challenging God. You are wasting your time. Do not stand and be a word will come for you or something. You will not take it serious. You are wasting, you are disturbing yourself. You are not disturbing anybody. Because the word is for you, it's for your betterment. If God says maybe do something, do it. Do it.
Yes.
Do it. Your own is to do it and be quiet.
Je fais descendre mon feu, le baptême de l'esprit.
The presence of the Holy Spirit. That's what she's saying.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We serve a God of power.
Amen.
We serve a God.
Amen.
We serve a God of signs and wonders.
Amen.
Jesus.
Let your calling keep on activating.
Amen.
Angels of God, take control. Angels of God, take control. Put your hand on her head now. Angels of God, put your hand on her head. Put your hand on
her. Les ténèbres sont en train de passer, guéri. Que tout un chacun place sa main où il est malade. Je vois les anges la guérison.
Put your hand wherever is paining you for healing. The angels of healing are taking place. That is what Amen. I just said a few minutes ago. And the atmosphere is saturated. Let the power of healing
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Come to pass.
Amen.
Marital settlement.
Amen.
Settlement. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Je vois le feu. Je vois le feu descendre sur la tête de Sharon. Je vois le feu.
Yes. Yes.
Jesus.
Yes. Worship and anointing.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you. Amen.
Amen. Let's just clap offering to the Lord. Clap offering. Clap offering. Clap offering. Clap offering. Clap offering. Everyone, please. Clap offering. Everyone. Everyone, please. Clap offering to the Lord.
Thank you,
Lord.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you. Let me start. I can't hold.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm so sorry. When you start, I can't control it.
No. How can you control the Spirit of God? The Spirit of God controls everybody. It's a great privilege for God to use you to announce what He is saying. To give Him all the praise and worship. And we say, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Amen.
Great honor. I see. That's what we are saying here every day. That is what we just I think we preached today.
Amen.
Yeah, that's also what God, the Spirit of God led us today. Acts 12:4-10. The release of Peter from the prison. The release from Peter from the prison. That's what is happening today is what we just deliberated on. That's what is happening now. God is actually practicalizing it.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We are actually practicalizing it now.
Amen.
The release. He was not only released from the prison, but he was taken, and the iron gate was opened.
Open.
On its own.
Yes. And he went out of the narrow streets. And that is when the angels of God departed, because assignment accomplished.
Amen.
That's what is happening. Anywhere that you have been blocked, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, let that iron gate open.
Amen.
Mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I open the iron gate.
Amen.
And those other gates that are already open, and enlarge the ghost of that gate.
Amen.
From north, south, west, and east. Enlarge.
Amen.
And the gate shall not be shut. Let the name of God be praised.
Amen.
Let the name of God, our God, be worshipped in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We are serving a living God.
Amen.
We are serving the God of power.
Amen.
God of power and authority.
Amen.
Because you can have power, but you don't have authority.
Yes.
So if you need power, you need the authority.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord.
Jesus.
Mr. Bibian.
Yes, Prophet. I wanted to give a message earlier, then the message went and it came back when Sister Nelly was prophesizing that we who are in London, we have privilege to be with or see the man of God. So as we are preparing to wait for him, we should prepare ourselves with thanksgiving. That pray over the thanksgiving for whatever you want God to do for you. Mm-hmm. You pray over it and you bless the man of God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sister Anna, are you not a witness? Look at what we spoke this by behind. Are we not a witness? God is truly a gossiper. Hallelujah. This is what we're planning. Thank God. Sorry, Prophet. I'm so sorry. I'm just being carried away. We were supposed to send that platform today and announce it. It would have been as if we're the one. All of a sudden, I just got busy. And then look at it. God is saying it. Oh, my goodness. Jesus.
Amen. It came the first time. It went. It just came
just
back.
Confirmation.
I have to say it.
And Colette were talking today.
Yes.
Thank you, Amen.
Lord. Ah, thank you, Jesus.
Wow.
Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
That is God. That is the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Jesus.
The Holy Spirit.
As Colette said, if someone doesn't know, they'll think it's a plan act.
I'm telling you,
and Colette, we're talking today.
Me and Sister Anna, we're talking about teach. We said if people want to sow their seed, they should pray for their seed. That's what I was saying. That if you want to give for your seed, pray for your seed, what you want God to do for you. Connect your seed. I was just telling Sister Anna, you see, God is good.
That is privilege for us. Privilege for
us. God hear us. God can hear. God can.
That's a God we serve. That's why you see, Hegai was running away. I will never forget because she was actually going. Don't go on the scene. Hegai, why are you going to twice?
Jesus.
My mistress drove me. No, don't go back. The God that sees me.
And I'm shocked.
Amen.
God is so close, brethren.
Nothing is hidden. I'm telling you.
No, we are naked in his eyes. And if we only follow the instruction of God, there is nothing that will lack. If we follow it diligently and open, we will see the wonders of the God we serve in this platform.
Amen.
He's so real.
It is our time.
He speaks. He's not a man-made God. Our God is a God with dignity and integrity. What do I mean? That when he says a thing, he does it. He does not explain. He just creates. When he says you are having a baby tomorrow,
I am sure
that I'm not having a husband, you will just receive it.
I am sure, but I'm not surprised, but I am sure.
Hey. If you listen to Sister Bibian's message to this altar, what God says to her, if you listen to her encounter, you will marvel at the God in this divine favor ministry. This altar of fire is an altar that the Lord established for a purpose.
Amen.
Wait and see what altar.
Amen. We give God all the glory.
Amen.
Yeah. Let's pray for instructions. And we thank God
for using Sister Bibian to give out his message, not only this message, but other messages which have come through her. Same thing as Sister Nelly also, God passed through her to give message. That one is telling us that we are on the right path in the time, in the things of God. Keep trusting in God. Keep trusting in God. Keep trusting in God all the time. Keep trusting in God. That is a problem. So we stand in the place of God. We stand in doing the things of God by whatever thing that is happening. So we just keep on trusting in Him. You see what Sister Nelly said? The presence, the God was telling you that I am in your presence.
Mm-hmm.
I am in your presence. I am in your presence. Like what Sister Bibian have just said. God have said those people who precisely are around when the man of God, when I'm by the grace of God, is taking me to London. When I'm around, they should do what God have said. That's the message God gave to us.
No. Sister Bibian, somebody who just joined have missed the message. If Sister Bibian can repeat what the Lord said to the people of UK who are opportune to see the prophet one-on-one.
Yeah, I'm going to repeat it, that the Holy Spirit said that we who are in London, is a privilege for us to see and be in contact with man of God. So we need to ready ourselves by sowing something.
A thanksgiving offering.
Thanksgiving of something and pray over it before we bless the man of God.
Amen.
Wow.
Now that's divine intervention.
Anything that you have been doing due to instruction, God honors it.
God, thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Thank you,
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Colette, is your hand up, or you want to say something?
Yeah, I just have a small thing I saw, because there is a market here. It's a market in UK. They call it Marché de Fleurs. So I don't know whether it happens yearly. I've never attended it, but sometimes I would just want to drive past. Then I will see that day was a Marché de Fleurs. So when we were, it's a flower market that they come and show for various kind of flowers, beautiful flowers. So when we were praying, I just saw the gate of the Marché de Fleurs. So I just saw it. So I was like, I don't know. Yeah.
That's honeymoon. As you are talking like that, the Spirit of God is telling me honeymoon.
Amen.
Holy Spirit of God is saying honeymoon.
Wow, hallelujah.
With marital settlement.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, all those who are looking for partners, who are looking for marital settlement, Lord God, settle them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Amen.
Also, those who are already into it and the devil want to come and disturb them, Lord God, send the devil out and settle them well in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Lord God, there is nothing too hard for you to do. Do it and take the glory. To be nothing in glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
In Jesus' mighty name.
So.
Thank you, Lord.
I've just been led that anybody who wants to tap into this. Anybody that wants to tap into this marriage, sow something now.
Amen.
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 Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Well.
Amen.
Well. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Sow something now.
I cover our prayers with the blood of Jesus. I cover our prayers with the blood of Jesus.
Jesus.
We have anything to say again, please?
Yes, Prophet. I would just want to give the announcement again about testimonies. It's been a while. Some of us have not sent our video testimonies. Please, please, please keep sending your video testimonies. We need that because it really helps to build the faith of the faith, build our faith, and also those that we're evangelizing to show the power of God through our prophet. Please. Thank you. I'll be calling a few of us which have started already to remind us on it, please. Thank you.
It is well. Sister Naloa, your hand, you put your hand up. Your hand is up, please.
Yes, Papa. Good evening.
Good evening, Sister Naloa.
Good evening to everyone in the house.
Good evening.
Yes, Papa. I just wanted to talk about, as you were praying for me that yesterday.
Yes.
When you were praying for me, something really wanted to happen, but the line just went off, and then I tried to connect again. When you say, let me put water on my hand. When I put the water on my hand was shaking. Along the line just cut off, and I could not join again. I tried to join for me to complete the prayer. I could not join.
No problem. You have the God of yesterday, see the same today, and the same forever.
Amen.
So just repeat and continue to put that water now in your hand. The same thing that happened to you yesterday will happen now.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Fire.
I put the water.
Salakata nekisikita pakata. Salakata nekata. The fire of God. Lord God Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you are water, water is you. Take control, Heavenly Father. Angels of God, take control. The right hand of man is the right hand of God. Let the power, Lord, that you have bestowed upon this hand, let it strength. Let it move now to her. The mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Let it move now to her. The mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Leave her now. Go out of that body. I say out of that body now. The mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Let that water break down everything that is blocking your system. Out. Out. Out.
Amen.
Wipe your face now with that water three times. Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit.
As that cleansing is going on with your face now, let the power of God keep on falling in you. Let that connectivity now fall. Let that divine anointing fall in you. Darkness and light have no friendship. Darkness can never comprehend with light. No one day. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. 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 The mighty name of Jesus Christ. Mighty name of Jesus Christ. I remove every blockage in front of you.
Amen.
Spiritual mold out of your body.
Oh,
out
Jesus.
Of your face.
Amen. Amen.
Mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Amen.
Mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Amen.
Release you to go and do the work of God.
Amen.
Open your mouth to say more of the things of God.
Amen.
Jesus' mighty name. Wherever
Amen.
You
Amen.
Let the Bible be your companion.
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus mighty.
Amen.
Cover you with the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
Cover you with
Jesus.
Jesus.
Amen.
Cover you with the blood of
Jesus. Amen.
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 Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Papa.
Yeah, thank you. You have seen that the power that was with you yesterday, the same power of today now. That's the God we serve.
Amen.
And He loves you.
Amen.
Amen.
Keep on surrendering yourself to Him.
Amen.
Believe in Him. Have faith in Him.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. Take the Ten Commandments to be your mirror. Everywhere you are going to, let the Ten Commandments be your mirror.
Amen.
Amen.
Everywhere you are going to, just take look at it. Just say, this is my mirror. My mirror is my Ten Commandments. That's how you will live a very good life in this, in the things of God.
Amen.
Because what will be happening with you is that you'll be having that wisdom. Yes. And those people who believe in the things of God, when they're having wisdom, it means they are having the fear of the Lord.
Amen.
As you see that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
Amen.
Because when you are becoming wise in life, there are certain things that you will not allow yourself to be used.
Amen.
But rather, you will use those things because why? You have command upon them. You have command over them. They don't have command over them. Yes. Now as I'm talking, the power of God is increasing in you. That you are having that urge now to read the Bible. You're having that urge now towards the things of God. I'm talking to you.
Amen.
The little that you have, you always struggle to share with people. That is where you have a lot of, that's where your blessing is coming from. The little you have, you are sharing with people.
Amen.
Don't change that business. Don't change that business. That's what the Spirit of God is telling me to tell you.
Amen.
Because that's where your blessing is. Yes. That new business that you have been discussing to go into it. Don't go into it. Which new business you wanted to go into it?
I just wanted to add drinks.
Okay.
And food.
Yeah. Just continue with the one you are having now. That one will give multiplication, but don't stop this one because this one is actually your movement. Because you use this one, people come and sit there for nothing and you preach for them, you tell them about God.
Yes, Papa.
Yes, but you don't know that what you are doing is very great evangelism that you are doing. It is important. And some of those people now, they are believing in their mind the things of God. You are winning souls. One soul on earth which is being won, heaven rejoices. So you cannot
Amen.
Want it. That is why you are having that upon your business. Business expansion. That is what is coming to you. Business expansion.
Thank you, Jesus. I receive it.
Yeah.
I receive.
Business expansion.
I receive.
I cover you with the blood of Jesus. I cover
blood
you with
the blood of Jesus.
I cover
blood
you
with the blood of Jesus.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Keep on trusting by the grace of God. By the grace of God, this is it's a platform, an apostolic platform and a prophetic, but operating in the office of a prophet. Yes. So if you are there, connect with your mind, connect with your heart. God will see us through. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
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 Mama, yeah, you want to say something?
Sister Naloa, the prophet just prophecy. My dear sister, that kind of prophecy of expansion, what you do, tap into the prophet account and said to God, let it come to pass in Jesus' name. So when you are tapping for the expansion, yeah, so tap on the account of the prophet for your prophecy that will complete it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 It is well.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
God bless you, prophet.
Yeah.
God bless you.
God bless you, sir.
It is well.
Amen.
Thank you, yeah.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. Sister Shella. Minister Shella.
Yes, sir.
Yes. You, there is something that you have to tell me. What is that? Where are you?
Sir, Minister Shella or Sister Shella?
Minister Shella.
Minister Shella. Okay. Okay.
The woman of God, the prophetess of God, you are the one who has to say something. There is something that you have to tell me.
Greetings, sir.
Greetings. I'm not seeing your face. Yeah, I see you now.
Okay, sir. So it's just that the thing I want to say is not completed, so that's why.
It's not completed?
Yes.
So you are hoping for God to be complete?
Yes.
If God can reveal it to me when it's not completed, you don't know that as you are revealing it is complete.
Amen.
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 It's because I didn't get the it's because I didn't get the thing clearly. That's why I said that I didn't get what I had to say clearly.
Okay.
So that yes, I didn't get it clearly. So I can't really say it because it's like I'm just saying that I passed through a door, then I'm just standing there.
Yeah, it's like leaving the prison yard. And the gate of the prison was still locked. You could not go out. Yes. Act 12, 4 to 10. That's what it tells us. When Peter left from the prison, everything, he started, how the manifestation started, how? The chains on his hand, everything fell. Now the doors of the prison opened by the angels of God. He went out. But the iron gate was still standing there. What happened again? The angel of the God opened the iron gate. Now he went outside and the angel of God departed from him, which means mission accomplished. That is what Sister Sela is saying.
Amen.
The doors have been opened, but the gate has not yet been opened very well. So she doesn't know how to say it when the gates have not been well opened. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is well. We hope by God revealing that there is something that you have to say which has not yet been finished. We hope now that the thing will come to pass so that God's name be glorified.
Amen.
Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
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 Jesus.
What about that guy? The guy who was disconnected from society by the Holy Spirit, by God. The guy, guy we prayed for.
Yes, I communicated with him. First of all, first struggled to communicate with him, and you write him, call him. They said, I think he was giving me a message that his phone was bad. Yes.
Okay.
So I asked him. Okay, then he told me that he's just afraid, and then. He said another thing that which I just canceled him, and then he was telling me that his phone is really disturbing him. So he said that situation, things are just difficult. I just told him that he should be patient. He said he's just thinking how he has to make it in life. I just told him that he's the one pushing himself to go and enter society, because since you have been prayed upon, you should just concentrate with God. God will put you, or God will bless you at this time.
True.
So if you are thinking how things are difficult, you want to make it sharp. So I just told him like that, and I told him that at least you have to thank God
for life,
for what. So
when
God
I communicated him again in your life,
phone has the prayer problem.
Okay.
So it's it can go online, or I don't know.
Yeah, just that
people, this God who is taking care of us is very merciful. You have just been disconnected. They put you in a society that you're supposed to die. And it was this Tuesday that just passed now. That prophecy came. And we prayed upon. Yes. It was last week that we encountered with him. Mr. Sheller called me. An emergency case of somebody who have gone and entered occultist society for money without knowing. Now they are pursuing him. He just seen the people in dream. When I went by the grace of God, God led, prayed for him, gave a prophetic assignment, and he followed. The next day, say he was just vomiting. Is that vomiting? Disconnection. Disconnecting himself from the all what they have given him without him knowing. Because you think they will not give you physical. Spiritually, when they are coming in the night, that's what they come and give you. Attached to you. Because why? Your body and flesh have entered the place. Your body and your soul, your spirit have entered the place. So now your spirit is already with them. Their shadow is there, so they can manipulate you. That's what was going on with him. So the spirit of the God gave instruction. And now he discoordinated himself to come and give glory to God and do something to God. Even for 1 second. That is how God is. People don't appreciate. Very soon tomorrow, you see something will happen. You say, oh, I'm sorry, Heavenly Father. It's just that we serve a merciful God. It's always good to glorify his name.
That's
when
right.
He has done something for you. Yeah. Always, always. Very important. You saw the other lady in America. 3.5 weeks, madness. In the house with the parents. She could not sleep. But immediately I was contacted by a brother of mine who is in the US. Prayed. Instantly she received a healing.
Amen.
Vomiting what they gave her. Immediately vomiting. Everything. She insanity finished. Up to the extent that after she went to bed immediately because she had not slept for 3 weeks. Immediately she went sleeping. As she got up, she cannot carry the children to school, something that she couldn't have, she cannot do for the past 3 weeks and 3 weeks and 3.5 weeks. She cannot do it. That is God. But now to come and give the testimony for what God have done to you. But you have already gone from one hospital to another, spending thousands of dollars. But no way, they could not see anything because it's spiritual. Now God have come, have healed you to say, Papa God, thank you. Mm-mm. It's not good.
Okay.
Yes. So we always need to give testimony. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay. Can I say something, sir, please?
Yes, woman of God.
I was waiting that as you'll be running up, I will put my hand up to say this.
Okay.
There is something we do respect and as this platform, it is a church, and that there are some things that I might see that maybe it drops my spirit that I can share it. For example, like I'm just quoting an example of today, what has been going on the platform. Like I don't know, this sister is, I think Sister Bibiana. Yeah, so I noticed that after she spoke and then you said the spirit of God is taking over her. I believe that part like that was, like you say, God wants to speak. I believe that part was for us all to be silent. And listen.
Yeah.
To be silence and listen. There's nobody that is a robot or whatsoever, like, let me say, sometimes they are listening when God is speaking, when the spirit of God is speaking. It's a human.
Yeah.
The person can be distracted. A little voice can just distract. God uses the person. So the person itself, which is human nature, must be distracted. So I discovered that God insisted this evening, this hour, to talk to many on this platform.
Yes.
That particular part was a little bit distracted.
Yeah.
And then God still insisted now to the other sister.
Nelly.
Yes, God now insisted to speak. No, yes, the other sister now. The other one that was to sing. The other one that was to sing like
yes,
that.
Sister Doris.
Yes. So that hour that the atmosphere was like that, and I'm just pleading. That is just what it was heavy in my spirit to. Yeah. This is what it's heavy in my spirit to say. So that hour that she, that song was coming out, it was still part of God speaking. And then the platform was too noisy, and now it was not easy, because that song was supposed to come out in the middle when you prayed for the sister Bilan, and what, as we were saying, that the Lord want to speak.
Yes.
Okay. Now we postpone, push now before while you were now giving prophecy, because it was easier when that hour. I don't know.
The hour has come. Yes.
So now, if it was not prophecy now, she could have not come out with that.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And then now, it went now to Sister Nelly. Because those things, I picked it very carefully. It went now to Sister Nelly. The Lord was insisting on this platform to speak today very widely.
Hallelujah.
Most of us were disconnected. Mm-hmm. We're mixed when God was speaking,
we're making noise. I singing, so we're praying. I just them muting people.
So now when the Lord wants to speak, now we want to speak with the Lord, and then it's affect the atmosphere. There was a message given to Sister. There was a prophecy given to Sister
Bibian and Nelly. The both of them had messages.
No, it was my sister Regina.
Sister Sharon, Sister Anna.
So now Anna, that was
God. Anna also.
Yes, that was God.
Love noise.
That was God walking.
A flower and there's a fire on your head.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So that was God.
That's what the Spirit of God told Sister Nelly as concerns you.
Amen. Yeah, I heard my name. But I don't know pick up what she said.
She didn't pick it. I noticed that she didn't pick it because, there was a lot of distraction, and this particular part like this, for me, I don't know about any other person. It caused my spirit to be heavy, because that I want to listen. But now, as other voices were speaking, I don't know which direction now to listen. And then many people, God was speaking to them. They could not get it because the atmosphere was somehow. See, now it's now that she's hearing because I am saying it. But God has spoken already.
Best like she was God sleeping, because when they were talking,
already. I was awake. I heard my name, but I did not. I heard a lot of noise. So
my dear sister, we don't have to argue. Let's be quiet when somebody is speaking. You don't have to argue.
Can I say something, please?
Yes.
It's very, very true what sister is saying, because when prophet was, he started praying with me, when I can't, I have message coming.
Please, go on video.
I'm in a bathroom already.
Oh yeah, sorry.
Sorry. Let me go out.
Okay.
Yes, as I was saying, when prophet was praying with me, for me, the message was coming, and the angel was all over the place. So that's why I say, I don't know if you people hear me, because I was not in flesh anymore. I said that everyone have to kneel down. So the message was coming, but because there was so much noise, even myself, I couldn't catch the message. That's the time where I get the message for sow a seed for God, man of God, when he's coming to London, but I couldn't hear it properly. Till when our other sister was prophesizing, the spirit was talking to her, that it came back again to me. Then I said, I have to give this message tonight. So it's true what my sister is saying. When something like that, we need to really stay quiet and start to adore the Holy Spirit.
And be in the Spirit.
Yes.
Quiet and be connected. Be in the Spirit.
Yeah. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Okay. So that is just something that I just got while ministration today. And my heart was so heavy because I knew that there is something. It's not only the prophet that will be speaking and then we pay attentive. As God was speaking, we needed
anybody
to pay attentive. And when he's using anyone, we don't need to be attentive. That is just and I was like, let me not say it. I don't want like to say it maybe in my
anybody who,
no, it's good.
Minister Shella, anybody who is ready, God is available for you. That is how it is. That's why in the Bible, a donkey was used to pass message. Yes. So connect yourself. As Mr. Sela is just saying, anybody, God can talk to you to pass a message. Like how you just did now. Your own is what? Be connected. Connected. Be spiritual. That is all. Yeah.
And then, can I run up, sir?
Yes.
And then another partner, we are on, it's a network. So sometimes that when a song comes up like that, everybody is singing, we will discover that how since we are in different places. You get it? So when all of us we are singing, we don't have to be sensitive, spiritual sensitive. When all of us we are singing, you have to be listening from your own side, seeing whether it blends or how it goes. Because sometimes it is just so some people can everybody can sing, but now they should avoid that volume should not come too close so that it should strain the platform or the service. So those are some things that I just got that makes my heart to be heavy. I said, no, let me release it before I carry and go for bed.
That was very true.
Thank you for that correction.
Thank you. We are learning. It's a learning curve.
Thank you for God for leading you.
Thank you.
To give those vital points and let God continue to inspire everybody in the platform so that we stand and be connected in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Recover ourselves with the blood of Jesus. Cover our children with the blood of Jesus. Cover our loved ones, our family members with the blood of Jesus. Cover all the men and women of God doing the work of God on earth with the blood of Jesus. Those under persecution, we cover them with the blood of Jesus. Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Any other thing, please? Any other thing? Okay. Thank God for today. We thank God for the gift of life. We thank God for blessing us today. We thank God for gathering us today. As he himself said, when two or three are gathered in my name, I'm in their midst. That is why he was in our midst today. That is why we saw him in present, speaking through Sister Bibian, through Sister Nelly, and insisting in Sister Nelly that I am here. I am here. I am here in your midst. Why? Because we are gathered and calling his name. Let our mind be pure. Let our yesterday do not mar our future. Let the life that we are living today, we are living in Christ. Let it continue to inspire us in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
1,000 shall fall at thy side, 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come near thee. Only with thine eyes shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Let us go in peace and serve the Lord.
Amen.